Chris here. Today, I'm going to show you how to make tissue art that also in yummy fruits. So, I made pineapple and a pear. So now, I'm going to show you how to do an apple and also a banana. So let's get on to the video. Let's go. So the first thing is I'll keep this aside. And I'm doing two, so we need two tissues. So we just keep that out and take one tissue. This is a messy one, but it's worth it to make beautiful tissue art. So first thing is that you dip your top, only your top one, in water and take your red paint. And you dip it two times to get it even watery. So then you just dip, and you have to not follow the same pattern. You can do however you want in crisscrosses.
Industry point of view, remember one thing, if anything is going to be unable to handle some data or something issue, we are not going to take any individual action everywhere. Just we are going to report to the team if it, this is this record or this running or unable to process.
So you just keep on, and you also need a toothpick. I'll tell you later for what it is. So first, we finish damping. So you have to always, every time, you have to dip and then press and again go and dip to make it. And after you're done, you just wash off your finger. Then take this. And then, on the top there's a brown stem, you just have to dip in your hand and just attach the color to the toothpick. Then, you just keep it up.
Suppose you go for an example like whatever it is, that you made, right?
So, again, you just dip and continue. If you want, you can just do from the top.
Take a simple example. Arthur, before arthritis is one part and after arthritis is one part. You can create one.
So just continue on keeping stems, and then we have one more part with the toothpick, which I'm going to tell after finishing this. And the great thing is that you have to not smudge with water like the other craft of tissue art. So that's really good, because we just, after finishing, we just leave it for dry, and then we just get the beautiful piece of art. So that's why my colors didn't either mix. So you just keep on dipping, and at the last time, after you do there, just wash away your paint, then you dip your finger in green, you just keep like little leaves. So here, when you get that water, you can just dip. and drop. Dip, drop. You just keep on continuing. So you have to only put long mini ones, so that's why you only need to use the tip to keep the leaves. And after this, putting the leaves, I'm going to show you how to make one banana, and you also need a stencil for that, or you can do it like that. So I'm not trying to do the stencil, and I'm trying to do it using a toothpick and hand. So this is no tools, so if you don't have a paintbrush, so there's no, because you need only finger and a toothpick. So you just continue doing it. I just have four more left. One, two, three, and four. So done. So I'm going to just keep tin in the water. And this is how it looks. There's a finished product of apples, and now I'm going to show you how to make a banana. So I'm going to just leave it down for drying, and I take the other paper, just wash away my hands, and then I just dip in for some yellow, and you just draw like this.
Suppose there is only two, instead of specifying the two output ports, we can use one is the default and one is the user defined. Yeah, we can do it. Okay, you can't assign it, it is allowed to use.
You just continue.
Then you can go for a two, right? Then you can specify the head. Okay, but if it is specifying is the three output fields are specified here.
So just keep on dipping, and after you're done, you have to also have some extra touches that you're going to do with a toothpick and make it look realistic. So after you're done, I'm going to just wash away, and then I'm going to just dip. Wash away my hand, and then go. So you need lots and lots of water, because these prints are fast dryable, so that's why you need lots and lots of water. Then you just draw the stem, and also make it look realistic with some spots. And you have to do it like that all over. So let's do. So first I'm drawing the stems. So just putting a line, it's not much hard work. For the stem.
You are one set with always starts with alphabet only. First one is alphabet. After you can make it any one. You can specify it. Yeah.
So it's just easy as pie.
Your email always starts with alphabet.
So I just have two more, which I'm going to finish.
This capping. Then 0 to 9.
So done, and now I have to put 3 spots to each banana.
Then allow for other one is you are allowed hyphen and as well as underscore. Right? Then upgrade is a delimiter. Then gmail dot com. Right? In this one, what happens is
so you just continue doing that.
For yes is for yes is a it's nothing but slashes never a space. But this is not a user upgrade is a user defined tag. That's why you can specify the upgrade. Here is slash, that is slash. That is slashes means it is in building one. Yes. Now you can see here is your
so after I'm done. So this is the finished product. And also please subscribe because we love you to join our beach family. Thanks for watching. Bye guys!